Hi guys, this video will be an update to my setup for Shadow Creatures with a focus on the new Ancient Invention perks. I'll be showing you the new perks, what's their effects and how to get them. I will also show you my updated preset and a couple of tips at the end of the video, so stay with me. Okay, first, why Ancient Invention perks? This is because you get new perks and higher rank perks which will translate to more kills per hour. Before the update, I was getting around 750 kills per hour, and now with the new perks, I'm getting around 810 kills per hour. And that's a nice 8% gain. And this is only changing the perks and not the familiar or the relics which I will test out in the future. But for now, I just want to talk about the perks because they are really amazing. Okay, quickly, how do we get the new gizmos and the components? For the gizmos, you can either unlock it at 95 Archaeology at the Stormguard Citadel or buy the blueprint on the GE if you don't want to train a skill. Next, here is how you get the components. The first option is to buy the component crates off the GE, but prices can be a little steep now. Or you can disassemble artifacts or materials for the components. And here's what I did. So for historic and classic components, I disassembled low level artifacts because the higher ones don't seem to give them. So the easiest way is to camp the Zaro stick site for the low level ones. And at the point of making this video, the level 17 ones, the Zaro's effigy and the Zarosian training dummy are the cheapest to make because the materials are the cheapest. But prices do change, so please double check. For time-worn and vintage components, I disassembled spare high level artifacts that I did not need for any collection locks. The higher the level, the more components per artifact. Okay, before I move on to the perk combinations, I want to say a big thank you to the RS Wiki and all the contributors and the RS Archaeology Discord. There's a very useful perk calculator on the RS Wiki website which I will link in the video description. First, the weapon. The perks I have are Aftershock 4 Precise 2 and Equilibrium 4 Ruthless 3. The components needed are 6 Illujunkan, 3 Armado, 8 Time Worn components. Aftershock is pretty self-explanatory, is the best perk here because of its AoE effect. But what's better is that you can combo it with Precise 2. And you may be thinking, why Precise 2 and not Precise 6 on its own? This is because in our second gizmo we have a crazy combo, Ruthless 3 and Equilibrium 4. So what Ruthless 3 does is that it increases your damage by 0.5% per rank for 20 seconds per stack, and it stacks up to 5. So simply put, it increases your damage by 7.5% whenever you are constantly killing enemies. And the 7.5% is very similar to what you will get with Precise 6, but it is comboed with Equilibrium 4, which cannot be done for Precise 6. For bossing, Precise will likely be better, but for farming Slayer monsters, I think this is better. And don't forget, we still have Precise 2 on our Aftershock gizmo. So this is already a big improvement over our old setup with only Aftershock 3 and P4E2. But wait till you see the armor perks because those are crazy. Okay, for the top, I have Impatient 4, Devoted 2 and Biting 4. The components you need are 6 Zemi, 3 Zaros, 7 Nox, 1 Direct and 1 Blade. This is a Shadow Creature focused setup, so I don't have Biting 4 combinations here, but you can look it up if you are interested. Same for Impatient 4, we are only interested in Impatient 4 and other combinations like Devoted 4 are not really interested here. Next, the bottom, I have Crackling 4, Relentless 5 and Scavenging 4. The components you need are 8 Vintage and 9 Precious. Okay, Crackling 4 and Relentless 5. This is a very good combination. Crackling 4 is already decent on its own, but Relentless 5 is out of the world. It has a 1% chance per rank to prevent adrenaline from being consumed when using thresholds and ultimates. And yes, it does work for ultimates, so you can zerg into Hurricane and Quake and very quickly charge up to get a Meteor Strike again. So I'm sure you can imagine how good it is already. And the last gizmo we have is Scavenging 4, but unlike Scavenging 3, which is super rare, this is like 1 in 16. And that's it for the updated perk combinations for Shadow Creatures. Before we go, let me just show you my updated preset. The Dominion Tower marker is just for player bonus. You can ignore it if you don't want or don't have it. And finally, just to reiterate a few points, the reason why I have one Blissful Shadow here is because they hit harder than the Truthful Shadows, so you can gain more prayer back from the Penance Aura. You also want to use the Scythe over the Zaros God Sword and stand at the spot here, because the Scythe range lets you hit the two spawn locations nearby, so you pull them in faster. And that's it for now. If you find this video helpful, give it a like to help more people see it. Subscribe for more Clue content, and I will see you in the next one. Happy Clue Hunting!